everyone, welcome to Walt Disney Wednesday, where every Wednesday we talk about Disney. Now, I was roaming through the parks this evening with my camera, because, you know, obviously that's one thing you'd want to do. But there's one particular building that I don't think a lot of people have actually really talked about in the history of the past, and that is this building you see right behind me. This particular building was home to not only Little Mermaid Ariel's Undersea Adventure, of course, but it was also the home of one of my personal favorite attractions here at the Disneyland, aside from like Guardians of the Galaxy, Space Mountain. It was one of my favorite shows that we had here in this building. So this particular attraction that I'm referring to is called Golden Dreams. It did open with the park, and a few years ago, they decided to stop said attraction because obviously they wanted to bring more of the Disney characters into the parks. One of the things you might not know is that in Disney California Adventure's opening, they didn't want any sight of Disney characters to be seen. They wanted to just focus on California itself, kind of the way Epcot Center did, and now they're kind of more implementing more Disney characters, if you will. Obviously, a couple years ago, they switched this building from Golden Dreams to now what is Little Mermaid Ariel's Undersea Adventure. Now, if you're not familiar with the story of Golden Dreams, don't worry, there's plenty of YouTube videos to go around, but the general idea of Golden Dreams, it was a look into the hardships, the struggles, and even the successes of California. And it was hosted and narrated by my personal favorite, Whoopi Goldberg, who played the role of Calafia, the spirit of California. She'd be kind of the nudge in the right direction when someone was going through a little bit of difficult time and they just needed someone to just say, you're going to be fine. Now, the only thing that does exist currently from the Golden Dreams era was going to be the one, the only, the Palace of Fine Arts Rotunda that does still exist today, but they've obviously freshened it up a little bit. But the whole rest of the facility is completely gone, doesn't exist anymore, which is kind of sad because I was like, oh, I want something from Golden Dreams here. What I really liked about the attraction itself was the message of, even though you're gonna go through a lot of hardships, you still are going to experience some great successes out of those hardships. So, let me kind of give you a backstory as you walked into this theater of what you were to see. You would, when you got into the theater, when they were ready for you, the doors would open, you'd walk in, you'd see these two statues of what looks like maybe like Whoopi Goldberg or something, and you sit down, they kind of give you an idea of what you're about to see, keep your hands, arms, feet, and legs, you know, da-da-da-da-da-da. Well, then what they would do is you would see this light glimmering and it would swirl around in front of these curtains, and then it would hit into one of the figures and it would actually turn into Whoopi Goldberg, and her face was projected onto these figures and kind of introducing, she's Calafia, she's nothing but amazing, and she's going to give you the history of California and the people who made California what it is today. And then you'd see the movie, and my personal favorite is there was a theme song called Just One Dream that was on a soundtrack that is now out of print, that was sung by Heather Headley, that kind of showed clips throughout California's history and the great people that made California come to life. And one of my favorite things is at the very end of the movie, you'd hear her say,
"What about you? You got a dream? Then bring it on, because this is the place."
Cool. It's one of my favorite messages of like, we are the Golden State. We're home of all these great golden dreams that are what gonna make California unique. Now, while I am sad that unfortunately Golden Dreams no longer exists, what I do appreciate is that because of YouTube and all this other stuff, we get to see that story still. So if you haven't gotten a chance, I'll place them somewhere in the cards so you can get a chance to see what this movie was like. So hopefully you guys will enjoy that. So that's gonna wrap it up for this video. If you liked the format of this, please like this and leave a comment down below. I just wanna get a feeler out of there of exactly what you think this content should be. Do you like that I go on location? Because I think that would help out a lot. So thank you guys so much for watching this week's episode of Walt Disney Wednesday. If you liked the video, please don't forget, like and subscribe down below. I release new videos every single Monday, Wednesday, and Thursday, and all of my social media links, including the link to Return Home, The Way I See It, and my Musical Monday Spotify playlist, are going to be located in the description down below. Thank you so much for watching, and as always, my name is Forrest, and remember, pink cake. Bye, guys!